everybody. Welcome to 2019. It is me, Stella Wild. I am here with your January tarot scopes. Very excited to get into this month's energies. There is a lot of energy to work with. That's almost too much to go into for just one tarot reading. So please, I have put together a monthly horoscope column, so please do check that out. I will leave the link in the description. It's on my website. It's a written horoscope for each sun sign, including some general energy information you'll want to know. So if you're into astrology, you know, you might want to check that out. Also, I am offering a year ahead tarot reading. It's a 20-minute reading that gets into your personal energies for the year ahead. And you can book that on my website. I am still doing regular tarot readings for the month of January as well. So if you have a personal concern, please do book a reading with me. And finally, I have put on sale the Jupiter in Sagittarius Luck and Opportunity Forecasts. These are a minimum half hour long readings, plus some, you get a transit calendar with that and some other stuff. So you might want to check that out. It's great, very easy to access, and you have access to it for the entire year. So it's not just like you watch it and then you don't ever get to see it again. You just have to create, once you purchase it, you create a little account on the on my website, and then you can log in and watch it as many times as you want. And that's true for the video products that I sell on the website. So that is something that you might be interested in. So the way I'm going to do the readings this month is I'm going to be doing a Celtic cross as usual. For some of you who have been watching for a while, thank you. You know that I kind of tune in and I wait till I hear what my spirit guides kind of want me to do. And they're telling me I need to use this deck, my very powerful Rider-Waite deck, and do a Celtic cross for you all. And also, they are telling me to pull an angel answer card for everybody in answer to a question that you may have and or kind of a theme for your year ahead. So I am going to start with the sign that had the most views in the month of December, and then the second most views, third most views, etc. And that's the order I will do the readings and release them onto YouTube. The other thing is I would really appreciate it if you would like, comment, share, subscribe, because these messages have really been resonating with so many people, as I've seen every month through comments and also through private messages. And the more we can get the word out and help more people with the information, the better it is. So let's spread the love. Okay. All right, awesome. Thank you for your help with that. And let's get into the readings. Hey, Virgo. How are you? You're number three this month. You were number three in how many views we had for December. So let's see what's going on for you for January. I really am interested in hearing how your December went, because you had a fantastic reading for December. And there was a lot of positive, good energy and love and money and like different things. So Virgos have been having some positive energy and positive readings coming through. So very interested to hear how it's playing out for you. So let's tune into January now and see. My Virgos, what is going on? Okay, let's see. Okay, and I will look at all of this, and then I like to give an overview first, and then I'll get into each card. This is very interesting. Gosh, this one card's been coming up so much for people this month. This is the third time, and I mean, I really shuffled, I sprayed my little spray to cleanse the energy out of these cards, and this card is your outcome card, and this card came up for Gemini and for Libra, I believe. So this seems to be a theme. Cutting things. Taking very decisive, really making up your mind about something and letting it go. That seems to be a very strong energy for January 2019, since it's coming up quite a bit. So it's very interesting here because we have some letting go and some fresh starts, but the card that's in your heart is you're feeling like you are not quite ready to move on yet. But outwardly, in the outward world, you will be moving on. But in your heart card is very interesting in this reading. Whenever I do readings, there's always one card, and I've just laid out 10 here. I didn't do my usual extending the reading when I extend a lot of cards off the outcome card of the Celtic Cross, because I'm trying to keep these readings a little shorter so I can get them uploaded faster for you to YouTube. But in any case, when I do a reading, no matter how many cards I lay out, there's always one that seems to kind of leap out at me. And it can be in a different position. It's not always in the heart, it's not always in the present moment. I mean, it can be anywhere in the reading. And the card that's leaping out at me for your reading is your heart card, the world upside down. So at the base of your reading, you have the Fool card. So this is all about bringing in this fresh new start, this fresh energy for January, which is great because that is working with the energies. We have Mars in Aries. We want to move ahead right when the year starts, where Mars is in its home sign, Aries, initiating that action. Fired up, we have the new moon partial solar eclipse on January 6th, followed by Uranus going direct. So this is all about initiating fresh starts, new energy. But in your heart, Virgo, I think you're wondering, are you ready? There may still be some emotional processing that you need to do. This card is showing up as influencing your outcome. So, as I said before, your outcome card is already the Ace of Swords. I mean, you're moving on, you're moving into fresh territory. You are being very decisive. I think you know very clearly what you want. This is in your environment. You know what you want to manifest. I think the idea is that there is still some lingering, I'm just going to say emotional processing about are you emotionally ready? I think that you are mentally ready, and I think you're clear on what you want, but it's the idea of am I really healed? I think that's part of it. I think the universe is bringing you in a beautiful new start. The thing is, you know, we often don't realize how terrible something was, and how addicted we were, and how chained we were, and how toxic it was, until we actually get out of it. And then it's like when you're free, you're like, oh my God, like how did I put up with that? Like how did I do that? Like you like go on autopilot. Like you after a while, right? You don't even realize all the energy that it was taking from you. All the energy that it was taking from you. And so now that you're out of it, and now that you've been in this much better space, particularly like for the last 9 weeks, this is the, you know, Nine of Wands here. The last 9 weeks, the last 15 weeks. So since the fall, when you've been really coming into your own, Virgo, and you've let go, this is in your past, let go of toxic situations, addictive situations, just really toxic stuff. You've let it go. You've let go and you're starting this, you know, you've been in this healing mode. You've been in this reparative mode in which you have been following your inner guidance. You've been having faith. You've been trusting and believing in yourself again. And you've been initiating those fresh starts. But in your heart, like I'm saying, in these emotions, you're kind of like, am I ready? Am I ready? You are ready. You are ready. There's just some emotional little cleanup to do. And in your near future, you have this 10 of wands upside down. I feel by right after, I feel like the 10th of January. I think this is a time marker for you. So right after this new moon solar eclipse on January 6th, I think this final bit of feeling burdened emotionally by the past, whatever's been holding you back a little bit from moving full steam ahead into your bright future, I feel by January 10th, that burden will be gone. Okay? I feel that you will put to rest any lingering, I feel like it's more self-doubts. It's self-doubts and possibly a little bit of. Do I really deserve this? So there's some of that going on. And yes, of course, you do deserve it. But there can just be a little bit of that going on. Like little, like, you know what I'm trying to say. Not self-esteem exactly, but perhaps even something like, I can't believe all this good stuff is happening to me. And you're kind of like pinching yourself. Like, really? It's really happening? Is this a trick? Like, because it's been kind of crappy. This is recent past. I mean, this has been, it's not, you're coming out of a period of a very difficult energy. And now that good new bright beginnings are beginning to show themselves, this is beautiful. And it's like, yeah, can I trust this? You can trust it. So it's just this little bit of lingering stuff because in your environment, we have this beautiful card. We have the Nine of Cups. My God, like by, I'm feeling 29 for you. I'm feeling 29. I'm feeling the 29th of January. Something very magical is going to happen. This is probably a wish involving some sort of work. This is in your hope and your fear. And this is also a writing card. So there can be, if you're looking for a job, it's very possible by the end of this, the 20, I'm just feeling 29 for you. There could be a new job offer. There could be a new professional association that eventually leads to a job offer, if that's the wish that you've been having. If you've been wanting to get work done around your home and you've been having a hard time finding contractors, as has been going on in North Carolina and probably in Florida too, where we had the hurricanes, like so many people got so much damage that, there's you can't get anybody to do anything because everybody's so busy working on everybody's houses, like so many repairs have to be done. And it's like you're waiting, waiting, waiting to get somebody to even just look at your roof. It's like that type of thing. So if you've been waiting and waiting to get some sort of project underway, repair work done at your home, that could be manifesting by the end of this month. This can also be, as I said, some sort of writing or creative project that starts percolating. Okay, this can even be the publication of some sort of creative project. Getting it out into the world because this is the networking card. This is like, getting it out there. So the other thing I was going to say is that Jupiter is moving Virgo in your, I always have to count my houses, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio. So in your fourth house. So please check out my Jupiter and Sagittarius luck and opportunity forecast because with Jupiter in your fourth house, it is bringing good luck, like I was saying before, to your home environment. So if there is something that you in particular want to manifest with your home, your family, your roots, this is, I think, the universe is going to bring you some sort of gift with that this month. So, definitely take a look at that on my website because it will give you additional insight into that energy. So for some of you, if the creative project has been wanting to get pregnant, that could happen. Okay, so that's another, another possibility if that's the wish. And it would, of course, manifest in 9 months, the nine card. So beautiful though, with this Ace of Swords here at the end. Gorgeous, gorgeous card. I'm gonna pause. I have to pause every 10 minutes or so because of my computer melting down. I'll be right back. So yeah, with this beautiful card at the end here, this Ace of Swords, this is taking very decisive steps forward based on real clarity of mind. That's what you have this month. Like I said, your heart, your emotions may be a little, may need to get caught up with your head, so to speak. And you may feel like you're doubting. It's more the feelings, though, not your mind. It's the feelings of doubting if you're ready to move on. But the cycle's already started. You're already moving on. You're already on the path, Virgo. So just embrace it. Just embrace it. You're on the path. So this is great energy, this Ace of Swords. This is a wonderful card. This is also a writing card because it's, the sword. I mean, it looks like a pen. So it is the writing card also. So if you have been wanting to initiate some sort of writing, publishing, public relations, blog, website, anything like that involving a lot of, communications, writing, very good time to initiate that, especially with this energy happening with Mars and Aries and also with this new moon solar eclipse on the 6th. And yeah, I think it's great. I think it's great. I think these cards are very favorable for you, Virgo. I think if this card is more like don't have the doubts. Work through any last minute jitters, any last minute little doubts you have about are you ready? You are ready. You are more than ready. Because this is behind you. You already did the hard work to let this situation go. And now it's just a matter of allowing yourself to receive, really receive the good things that are coming your way. You saw in December how that was already starting for you. Actually, even in November, December, we had excellent readings for Virgo that the tide was turning, like things were starting to change with the energies. And we see this even in this reading as well, that you are now, as I said, these are beautiful major arcana cards that we have here, that you are well on your way. You are following your right path now, Virgo. You were a little thrown off course before. You were getting swept up in some unhealthy things and some unhealthy people. There was a little maybe, when you sometimes get really charmed by somebody who's really not that good for you. And I don't mean just even in a romantic sense, but it could just be a friendship. Like the person's a little glamorous, they're a little interesting, and maybe, but there's like an edge there, but you're kind of fascinated by them. But they're not great. They're not really very good associations. They're toxic, they want to use you, stuff like that. So that's behind you. You're done. You did the hard work to get yourself out of that. You are now on the path of your destiny and of letting go of feeling like you have to work so hard, like that if you don't work hard, like you can't have these things, right? You don't have to like work hard, like you don't have to earn it, right? You have it just because you're you and because you show up as yourself and contribute your good energy to the world. Like you don't have to feel like you have to put on a show and earn love. Really, that's what it's about. You don't have to do that. And you get that now. You get that now. You're letting go. I mean, both of these cards are upside down. This is like letting go of the struggle, letting go of the burden, letting go of thinking, I really am feeling this, thinking that you have to like perform and earn the good things that want to come to you. All any of us has to do is show up and share our gifts. That's what we're here for. We're supposed to be here sharing our, this is what I believe, here sharing our gifts. Each of us has something to contribute to help others, to make the world better, to create love and peace, right? We all have that. Well, maybe not all of us. I won't even get into that. Most of us, most of us have that. So that's my point here, is that show up as you. Let go of this burden of thinking you have to earn things, right? You don't. Contribute your gifts on this new path, and you are more than ready. You are more than ready. All right, let's pull an oracle card for you. These are my angel answers. You can use this card as, why am I out of focus? Hello. There we go. You can use this card as the answer to a question, Virgo. We can look at this as a theme for the year ahead. We can look at this in relation to the reading that we just did. Whatever works for you. So what do my Virgos need to know? What is the angel answer card for them? I usually wait. Whoa, this one's popping out. You see, I wait for one to pop out. This is popping. Take action. It's time to take action. Take action. Take your decisive action because your mind is made up. You know what you want. It's time to go for it. It is time to go for it. That's going to be the title of your video. Time to go for it. Fresh start. New path. You're on the right track. Take action. Love it for you, Virgo. Love it. Okay, Virgos, I wish you a great January 2019. This is me, Stella Wild, signing out. I will see you next month.